So I moved somewhere in, and I chose this because it's part of the music industry that I am most interested in, and I've never really had a specific structure for when I write songs. I either get an idea for a melody or an idea for a lyric and then work with that rather than like having a process or thinking conceptually about my songs. And so then because of that, sometimes the songs worked and sometimes they didn't. And I was curious about how other people wrote their songs. Originally, I wanted to just have one original song that I would write before I studied or looked at any of the case studies. And then I'd have like verses or choruses that would relate to the songs that I looked at. But last Friday, I decided that I wanted to take more time, and if I looked at a case study, I'd write a full song rather than writing a verse and a chorus, so then I'd have like a more solid body of work. But that would mean that I would look at less of the case studies that I wanted to. So hopefully I'll have like 3 completed songs by the end of the 8 weeks. And each song will be very different from each other, because I'll be looking at lots of different influences rather than just me writing songs.
Sorry to cut in, just to make sure I'm clear. Are the songs going to be performed by you, or are they written for other people? Or are they going to be performed at all, or are you just creating a body of work?
Well, I wasn't sure if I wanted to perform, and I'm still not really sure.
Okay.
But I feel like I'm maybe made to perform one. So I'm probably going to perform them myself. I'm not sure if you necessarily have to.
I don't know if...
But I'm doing music performance, so kind
of...
I don't know. I mean, I don't really want to, but now that I'm making full songs rather than just verses and choruses based off the songs, I feel like there'll be a point.
You have got a work product.
Yeah.
Okay, rather than going, here's a verse and chorus,
yeah.
I wrote them in a...
Yeah.
Thanks, guys.
Bye.
Okay, so but the aim is to just write the songs.
Yeah.
Possibly, probably performing one.
Yeah.
Okay.
So I originally wanted to just do, I originally just wanted to do songwriting, but then I realised that was just a very vast task and I couldn't do it. So I thought maybe I'll pick a theme and that would help me focus it. And I decided to pick the theme of alcohol because it's not specific, as in, it's not so specific that it's only specific to one artist or one genre or one song even. It's, I can find lots of different songs that talk about it and talk about it in different ways, and it's not so broad as in like love, which you could argue is like every song is about it. So I wanted something specific but not too specific, so I chose alcohol. And these are the songs that I've chosen, and yeah, that's it. So how does it shape my project? Well, it's helped me focus, and it's helped me look at different perspectives in regards to alcohol, and I feel like there is a trend in different genres, there's a different interpretation of it. So in like hip hop and rap, there's sort of more of a, like a partying vibe and I'm gonna do what I want kind of thing. And then in the indie side of it, which I looked at Elliot Smith Between the Bars, it's more somber, and talking about the restrictive parts of it and stuff like that, and the isolated parts of it. So the first case study I looked at was Elliot Smith, Between the Bars, and he uses a lot of extended metaphors, and he also, I feel like he personified alcohol because he's speaking directly, or he's speaking in the first person, and each verse starts with drink up baby, and it could be him talking to someone about him talking to someone else and encouraging them to drink. But I feel like it's like he's actually personified alcohol, and he's portraying like an alcoholic's like inner monologue about whether they should drink or whether they should not, and like talking about that as, and depicting like their isolation and things like that, which is like Between the Bars and sort of locked into the addiction. So that's what I used the idea of personification, and then I wrote my second song. And then within that I personified alcohol as friends, so that's this is what it is.
My best friends are my own, they take me to places you
questions?
Oh, yeah.
What have you learned so far from the Bob Dylan song?
The Elliot Smith, I've just started the Bob Dylan song. The Elliot Smith song, I've learned about thinking more conceptually about writing lyrics rather than just writing them and having a deeper meaning and using more like techniques to convey a story.
What were the major difficulties you faced while songwriting?
I think just it's very difficult to for me to write songs very quickly, and I was supposed to have I think about four verses, choruses, or four songs or case studies done by now, and I've only done like two. So I've been moving very slowly, but I feel like now that I've decided that I'm going to do full songs rather than just verses and choruses, I feel like that's okay because I'm more focused and I'm like I can incorporate lots of different artists and I can still incorporate the songs that I've chosen and just put it into one song rather than doing lots of different things.
Have you changed the process that you've done in so far?
Pardon?
Will you change the process?
No. I like the process. I pick a song and then I analyse it and I analyse the lyrics and the vocal delivery and things like that, and then I write my song, so I relay it back.
So would you, sorry.
How are you doing this analysis? The same question I've been asking most people. Is it like a step? Are you sort of what is the form of it? Is it just like a written sort of essay on each song?
It's not an essay. It's like a paragraph or two, and I look at sort of it broadly, and then I look at the lyrics and the different things that I pick up, and I go and with a highlighter and I print out the lyrics, and then I look at the lyrics in relation to the instrumentation, and then if there's like a thing that the writer has done that I really like, it could be small, it could be really big, like personification, which is quite big, or just a repetition of a phrase or something like that, then I pick that out, and then I talk about it, and then I write my song and use that.
Brilliant, okay. So all of that stuff, lyrics with highlighting and stuff, please just take photos of it all.
Yeah, I do.
Great. So you're documenting the step-by-step analysis, really. I guess that's what I'm trying to get across to everybody. And as the day's become more apparent, as we've gone on, it's become more and more apparent. That's the one step that sometimes you're missing.
Yeah.
Listening to something and then saying you used it for research is great for, like, past level, but it's not going to get any better than that. You need to actually say what you learned from it.
Yeah.
So what have you learned so far about
the songwriting models? I think I've learned that it's... I don't know, I think that I've learned that it's not just sort of you getting inspiration whenever you feel like it and then writing a song and it sounds great, rather than like it's more thinking conceptually and planning things out and really looking at what you're writing and what you're trying to say. So I think I have more of a focused idea of how I want to write my songs in the future, which is what I wanted.
Well, you know, for the rest of this project, you have like a bullet point kind of schedule that's going freely.
I have schedules in terms of songs,
mm-hmm.
So I'm following, I did the Elliot Smith song and now I'm doing the Bob Dylan song, and then afterwards I'll do the Nina Simone, Nina Simone song, Lilac Wine. Yeah, I might not get through all of them, like I said, but I might back them into one song.
So now you're basically writing lyrics for your songs.
Mm-hmm.
What about writing lyrics for other people? How would you approach this? Would the approach be different or would just be the same?
I haven't really looked into it because I feel like if I'm writing a song then it's for me or it's about something that I'm thinking about rather than me writing songs for other people and then saying I want to write something about this and then do that. I haven't really looked into it. I don't know if I'm gonna, I probably won't, but I'm writing. I'm sorry, if you want me to, I will, but I don't know if that's something that I'm interested in, because originally I was looking at singer-songwriters, because that was too what I looked at, like, the theme of how pop
music. How would you improve your process, if you like?
Probably speed up, just get more done, and write more, just have, like, solid songs.
What are you doing to ensure it's successful?
Well, I'm writing every session that we have, and I'm booking production rooms as well, and working on it at home. And I'm just always going over the lyrics and the songs that I'm studying that week. I like listen to it over and over again and stuff like that, and just analyzing,
learning things,
analyzing the songs, and yeah. But I'm not gonna say that I'll write 7 songs by the end of it because I know that I won't be able to. So I think 3 is a good amount because I've already written.
So you're not setting yourself too big a target, so you can be successful.
Yeah.
I think that's quite important, generally. Your stuff you've listened to,
mm-hmm.
How have you been listening to it?
What do you mean?
Like, I mean, do you Spotify, do you use YouTube? Do you
YouTube.
Own the CDs, do you own the records?
YouTube, and then I buy them on iTunes, because the Bob Dylan one, his version isn't available on YouTube, so I bought it. So I buy them, but I listen to them on YouTube, and then
this applies to all of you, actually, but just, especially, yeah, you've got a playlist of stuff there, so make it into a playlist. You can make a YouTube playlist really easily, and just include it as part of an extra part of your research, because you're probably documenting each one you've talked about.
Yeah.
It just makes it very useful if I was marking your work and I wanted to look at your case studies, it'd be nice to be able to go to a playlist and say, wow, these are all the songs. Then you may not necessarily write about every single one, but you can add everything.
Yeah.
It's a really good way of collating all your research. It applies to all of you guys. Any music you're listening to, if it becomes significant, put it into a playlist called FMP Research, and it all lives in one place, and then you can annotate and comment on the really important ones, but it just shows the listening that you're doing.
How did your case study affect your project?
My case study, my project revolves around my case study. But they affected my project. I don't know, they affected it well. I mean, obviously I have material and I have inspiration from the case studies that I looked at. And they kind of did slow me down, or I wasn't sort of like, I was picking the songs and then I was analyzing them, and then it takes a while to write the song. It's just sort of a lengthy process. I thought that it would be quicker than it is.
So when you're looking at the songs, you're looking at the different theme rather than lyrics.
I'm looking at them through a theme, and then I'm looking at how they address the theme through the lyrics.
Mm-hmm.
So, and then I'm just looking at their techniques of storytelling or narrative. Yeah, the instrumentation I think is important because it sort of supports the lyrics. And so they're between the bars, it's very minimal. It's just one guitar, and he's not very loud or anything like that. And it sort of made me focus on the lyrics, whereas some of the other songs are The King's Alcohol. There's lots of instrumental bits in it, so it's not solely focused around the lyrics. So.
In terms of feedback, I don't think there's anything I would say change or do differently. I think the whole process is really good. I think when it comes to the final delivery of your project, I wouldn't stress too much about trying to perform all of the songs, mainly because your original focus, I think that what you're getting out of this is enough for a project regardless of if you perform them or not. Although it is a collaborative performance project, I feel like your process is gaining so much from it. So don't stress too much about the performance aspect. But in that sense, do you have a band or an idea of who you want to play with?
No, well, the song that I showed you is just piano, so I think I could play that by myself.
Okay.
If I was going to perform. But then my first original, I did ask you to play guitar, but I haven't decided it.
Okay. So yeah, that would be my focus looking forward. I feel like your process and the way you're going about it is great. Just hone in on how you want to present the project. And if you're going to perform one of the songs, make sure you put aside enough time for rehearsal. If it involves band members, make sure they've got enough time for rehearsal. Because I feel that it's happening with everybody. We've got this 8-week sort of time scale with performance at the end. Half of that time should be allocated to rehearsing, really. So at this point, you should be thinking which songs are ready to perform. It may be that you finish the third song and you like it the most, but you didn't have time to rehearse it. So take that into account when you think about what you're going to perform. So you've got sufficient rehearsal time. You'll be able to do it justice. Any other comments, feedback, questions? Everyone wants to clap?